It's Q12 number 3 for 2017, and today we're up in the nether regions of the north of England, and there are 9 people competing for a place in part 2 of today's Q12 quiz. So we've got 12 minutes, which is going to be timed by my friend Dave Bill over there, my new bestie. And we've got 12 minutes and we've got some questions. These questions start difficult and protracted and hopefully get a bit easier as we wear on. Now, the kind of jeopardy with this is you get 2 points for a correct answer. An incorrect interruption, your penalty is lose half your points. Now, think about that. If you've got no points, go for it. If you've got 12 points, you might be better off leaving it alone. After 12 minutes, only one person will be eliminated. Only one person will take the dreaded walk of shame. So this is for a place in part 2 of Q12. And the current form player, I'm not going to go into it because this is going to be out in April. So, which Oscar-winning supporting actor plays American boxing promoter Frank Spedding in the 2000 film Shiner? Other Oscar-nominated performances were Tucker, The Man and His Dream, and Crimes and Misdemeanors in 1989. It was Martin Landau. Which Texas-born blues guitarist christened Albert Gene Drury was nicknamed the Iceman and Master of the Telecaster? His initials are AC.
Sorry, what was this?
Initials are A for Alpha, C for Charlie. Albert Collins. What surname was taken by Adele Casagrande in her leather and fur shop in Via del Plebiscito in central Rome when she married Eduardo in 1925, establishing an Italian luxury fashion house renowned for its stock trade?
McPay.
Gucci?
No. Worth a guess? It's
Rose.
Prada?
No.
Simon.
Versace?
No. It's Fendi. Tap tap. After its capital, Ayutthaya was destroyed in 1767, Thornbury, under the reunification of Taskin the Great, was the capital of which Asian country up to 1782?
Norman.
Thailand.
Thailand is correct. Norman, you are in the lead. Designated a new town in 1964. Where in Worcestershire do both have
Lee?
Greenwich. Long question. Do both Halfords and engineering giant GKN have their headquarters, and does the National Needle Museum commemorate the heritage of the manufacturing blah blah blah? Redditch, Lee, you're on 2. Back to normal. Name any member of the British Music Hall and Vaudeville Trio who capitalised on the fashion for ancient Egyptian imagery.
Turner.
Wilson.
Wilson is correct, yeah. It's in Norman. Wilson, finish it off for us.
Wilson, Keppel and Betty.
As featured in the Walter Scott novel Kenilworth, Amy Robsart was the wife of which...
Simon.
Robert W. L. Weston.
That's more than enough. Well done, Simon. It's loud as that, Tim. Prefixed with Vogue in the UK, on which subsidiary of Decca Records did Buddy Holly record?
Tony.
Coral.
Coral is correct. Uruguay's first ever World Cup defeat in 1954 was against which side, which, a year earlier, had inflicted England's first home defeat?
Tony.
Hungary.
Is correct. Where was Preston on that? Was he even in there?
Somewhere.
What was the... sorry, guys. Apart from Tony. What was the final UK number one of the 1960s?
Lee and Rhodes, both on a tie.
Oh, that's not me.
Yeah, don't use that. Because Lee, whisper the answer to each other.
He has
two little boys.
1 point each, I will give you. Lee for 1 point.
Back to Harris.
And Rhodes on a point.
Back to Harris Tweed again.
Yeah. Two little boys. I thought Harris might have been one of your artists.
Harris Tweed.
I got Harris Tweed. About the only one I got today.
The 15th largest island in the world and the 4th most populous after Java, Honshu and Great Britain. Roughly rectangular in shape with the long Baikal Peninsula or Bikal Peninsula.
Norman. Kyushu.
I'm afraid not. You lose half your points. The 15th largest, blah blah blah. After Java, Honshu and Great Britain, roughly rectangular in shape with a long Baikal Peninsula protruding to the southeast, which is the largest of the Philippine Islands.
MP.
Luzon.
Luzon is correct. Where were you, Lee, my friend?
Somewhere.
He was...
In which year The census revealed all you were people of nothing, you can go for this. Hello! You can join in for that. In which year did the census reveal the British population to exceed 21 million? Mary Shelley and J.M.W. Turner both died. Doc Holliday and young Tom Morris were born. And on May the 1st, the great exhibition of the working industry. Oh, somebody's going for this.
Simon.
1851.
It's correct. Crystal Palace, Hyde Park, London, opened by Queen Victoria. Give any of the collective nouns, defined by Wikipedia for hawks.
Norman.
Cast.
Yeah.
Yes,
boil, cast, and kettle.
Shite
about. Yeah.
Terror.
Terror.
Give it a time check.
5 minutes just gone.
In March 1960, who moved from Manchester City to Manchester City, sorry, from Huddersfield? Lee!
Dennis Law.
He is Dennis Law. How would you have been in there?
I'd have been in there.
What was the name of the frog in Hector's house?
Simon.
Kiki.
Kiki the frog. 16 questions. Despite formulating the concept and signing the covenant, which country most significantly never joined the League of Nations?
Simon.
USA.
USA. You're in the lead, but that's no big deal, really. But these points do go for your overall total for the year. Yeah. Stark, Popcorn, and Griddle. McPhee. Is correct.
What was the answer?
Novels by which motormouth?
Popcorn.
Pool pottery carries a mark featuring which animal?
Preston. A fish.
No. Which animal? A cetacean.
Dolphin.
Is correct.
Why is the dolphin a fish?
No, ask Gary Graft about it.
He's not a fish.
Preston, you didn't have any points, so you can lose half your points. Tony, do you get the points there?
Yes, yeah.
It's got one point,
I think. Dolphin.
No, I don't know.
What name is given to the horizontal pole used by dancers to help them maintain their balance while practicing?
Norman.
Bar. Bar is correct. Bar is people leaping up and down this table. When Spencer Tracy won his first Academy Award in 1937, his Oscar statuette mistakenly bore the name of which of Chester Gould's creations?
Tony. Sexton Blake.
No, no loss.
Isn't it?
And how can we know lots of
this? Norman, the question. Norman!
Dick Tracy.
Dick Tracy, it's correct!
Yeah.
Spectrum. La La Land! Born April the 22nd, born April the 2nd, 742 AD. Or, could have been 747, nobody's quite sure. Or even 728. But it was definitely April the 2nd. Who was the oldest son of Pepin the Short and Ben?
Charlemagne.
Lee, you were in front of Dave Bilner. Who played Hannah in the sitcom Faith in the Future and Sack?
Preston.
Julius Wahala.
I'm glad you can pronounce that. He always knackers me. Preston, look at you, leaping up the table above Rhodes. How many hours are there in December?
Tell me.
744.
It's correct. Were you in there, Lee? What handcrafts jargon includes garter, chevron, pavilion, windmill, purling, and casting off?
Simon.
Knitting.
I'm glad you got it right. Where is Badwater, the lowest land above water in the Western Hemisphere?
No.
Norman. He's absolutely correct, Norman.
Where was it?
Badwater, Death Valley.
Death Valley.
In the Western Hemisphere. Harry Belafonte and Boney M. Tony.
My name is Bonchild.
Good job you weren't long after lured you into a premature pause. You notice the Mike Leaf pause. In Coronation Street, who was the best man at Lennon Rita's wedding in 1977? He jokingly made a pass at Bette Lynch in 1979, proposed to Audrey Potter in...
Simon.
Ray Langton.
No, in... Simon, you lose half your points.
Oh, hell.
Tumble. Who was the best man at Lennon Reuther's wedding in 1977? He jokingly made a pass at Bette Lynch in 1979, proposed to Audrey Potter in 1981, and was twice elected the Mayor of Weatherfield. Preston.
Fred Elliott.
No. Rhodes.
Alf Roberts.
Alf Roberts is correct. Well done, Rhodes.
That's 9.5 minutes.
Referred to in several Sherlock Holmes stories, what is an ulster in the context of apparel? Simon.
It's an overcoat.
It is an overcoat. Full name wanted. Sebastian Tobes and Sugarman Treacle have been aliases used by which fictional character who at the age of 19 was nicknamed the Saint and his most the famous crypt is McPhee.
Simon Templar.
Yes, well, McPhee, you've been very quiet. Rightly so. How does one address a magistrate in an English court? Dean.
Dean.
Your Honour.
No. Tony.
Johnny.
Yes, Mr. Sir.
McPhee.
Your Lordship.
No. Anybody else? He knows.
I was trying to say the name.
Simon.
Did you pay?
Guilty.
No, it's your worship. No points. Looks churlish. Lordship. Which animal of the order Lagomorpha and family?
Johnny.
Rabbit is correct. Who was that?
Johnny. Chas and Dave.
Lou and Andy.
Dan.
Little Britain. It's correct. Well done, Daniel. You put yourself in a position. Come on, Chris. What number is in the middle hole of Augusta's Amen corner?
B. 10.
Unlucky. No.
13.
No. McPhee.
The 8th.
Tony?
11.
Rhodes?
17.
Simon?
9th.
Blake?
12.
Yes!
11, 12, 14.
Dan, what were you going to say?
I was
going to
say 13.
Oh, okay, well, thank you for being honest. Give me another round of applause.
40 seconds.
Of which cartoon is Stan Smith the type?
Dan.
American Dad.
Yeah.
I'm beat.
Oh my American God. Dad. Yeah, sorry.
Sorry.
Stop, go. Go. A Texas scramble is a form of what sport?
Simon.
Golf.
It's correct. Around which country would one find Arnhem Land, the Gulf of Carpentaria and Cape York? D.
Netherlands.
No penalty, Norman.
Australia.
Correct. The name of which material means from Sweden, as in the blue shoes? No.
Simon.
Suede.
It's correct.
Last question.
To two decimal places, what is the value of pi?
B. 3.14.
It is! Oh, check it out! Get out of here! Oh, what an exciting
12 minutes and 2 seconds.
Yeah, we'll read the last question. It's like the hooter at rugby league and carry on playing until what's it then kicks it out and doesn't go dead. Fenster and come back and score. Let me just put Bean on here. 2 points. Oh, what an exciting game. Well done, people. Take 5. In by the skin of his teeth, well done Chris, being on a fabulous strategic answer there. You assumed you were going to get it and you made sure you were first. And a few other people, I think one person at least does it after you. A very unlucky mark in the corner over there, but he'll live to fight another day. Part 2 of Q12 involves 12 questions and 12 questions only. But these questions are divided into 6 parts. If you answer correctly during part 1, you get 6 points. After part 2, 5 points, and so on and so forth, down to all the parts, 1 point, which is Trace from Essex standard. If you buzz in and you're wrong, you lose the appropriate amount. So it's a very high octane, high jeopardy game. Good luck, everybody. We have the card set ready to go. I'll make sure it's turned around the right way for 6 points. Are you ready, chaps? Top 4 go through to the final and a chance to qualify for the £500 game in December. Which place name is a city in Illinois, townships and former gold mines in New Zealand and Canada, towns in Queensland and Victoria, a subdivision in southern Austin, Texas, small town in Zabway and a neighbourhood of Bethesda, Maryland? Nobody's going to press on that. For 5 points, all are named, probably named, as the original village south of Stirling, and were created by settlers from the Scottish diaspora of the 18th and 19th centuries. for 4 points. A bridge built by Thomas Telford spans a stream. For 3 points, the stream after which the places are named. For 2 points, on June the 24th, Simon.
Bannockburn.
Is correct. 2 points for Simon. Top of the table. There's so much information on this, it's not even. Okay. According to the Guinness Book of Records, the 6 points, the record weight for what stands at precisely 20 pounds, grown by Peter Glazebrook of Newark in the UK. For 5 points, since it was recorded at the Harrogate Autumn Flower Show in 2014, relatives include, for 4 points, coriander, fennel, dill, cumin, cumin and parsley, which, for 3 points, which biennial plant grows a rosette of leaves while building up the taproot that stores large amounts of sugars to provide energy for the plant to flower in the second year. For 2 points, species of the genus Daucus, D-A-U-C-U-S. Despite the roots containing high quantities of alpha and beta carotene,
carrot.
It's correct. And there is vitamin K and vitamin C6. There is nothing to evidence the long-standing belief put forward by the British in World War II, belief that eating them improves night vision. So, Norman, points are hard to come by. Why am I pressing your name? What chain is made up of two separate groups? Nord, N-O-R-D, and Sud, C-double-dot-U-D, S-U-D, Sud. For 5 points, originally owned and managed by brothers Carl and Theo Albrecht. For 4 points, yeah, it's all very well pressing when you're getting it to 4 points, the richest men in Germany, for 3 points. The first store opened in 1913 in Essen, in Britain in 1989. For 2 points, spend a little, live a lot. Is it? Rose.
Did you buy Albrecht as well?
Yeah. For 6 points, born on Billie Jean King's 23rd birthday, whose quotes include, tennis is a psychological sport, you have to keep a clear head. That is why I stopped playing. For 4 points, the fifth set is not about tennis, it's about nerves. For 3 points, I love Nobu. They serve great food. I just have to remember restaurants are for eating in and nothing else.
Monopoly, Morris Becker.
It's correct. And you actually, with that for 3 points, it puts you in the lead. And on a quiz where the points seem quite hard to come by, what single name is shared by the recurring antagonist of the Trailer Park Boys, played by Bernard Robichaud? It says here, I've got work yes. to do. For 5 points, the Persian king of 4 sides of the world who took Babylon in 539 BC and founder of the Achaemenid Empire, who allowed the exiled Jews to return to Judah. 3. Ex-wrestler Steve Slocum, a.k.a. Jackson Andrews, who acted as Tyson Kidd's enforcer while on the Raw brand. 2 points, a girl with 7 things who under another name had the best of both worlds, and for 1 point, her dad who had an achy, breaky heart. Is that 5 points for you, Simon?
What about Jackson Andrews?
Yeah, I'm sure you would.
God, he's rubbish.
For 6 points, the single story or open tale version of which letter, don't be 27th in this one, of which letter is used in the International Phonetic Alphabet, but the single story or closed tale version is an acceptable variant. For 5 points, a letter is given to all British owned and operated commercial and private aircraft. Lee.
G.
Dash, dash, dot is the International Morse code, and in music it is written on the line below the middle line of the treble clef. a novel by John Berger that won the Booker Prize in 1972, which has been answered there by Clive, and D for Delta, which is the only other Scrabble letter to score 2 points. And I've gone through that question, so you're on 5 points.
Ooh, Lee.
Very useful. Please, what does it feel like to get 5 points in such a rarefied atmosphere? Just, you must think, wow.
A lot better than getting minus 24.
Yeah. Which 2016 film, directed by Justin Kurzel, has an approval rating on Rotten Tomatoes of 18% based on 171 reviews? For 5 points, it begins in 1492, which, for 4 points, which series took inspiration from the novel Alamut by the Slovenian writer Vladimir Bartol, while building upon concepts from the Prince of Persia series? For 3 points, Brotherhood, Revelations.
Assassin's Creed.
It's Assassin's Creed for 3 points. Black Flag and Unity is one of the incarnations of which, for 2 points, 100 million selling Ubisoft game initially featuring bartender
Desmond Miles
as a protagonist, who generally decides to complete the killing of public figureheads of a covert mission. 3 points for them, McPhee.
Should have had six.
Come on, nobody's negging on this. You all wind it. Which small market town has a tree-lined street, a main street that boasts a statue of Richard Southall Burke, the 6th Earl of Mayo, formerly an MP who became British Viceroy of India, and whose subsequent claim to fame was that he was assassinated? For 5 points, equidistant from Thornaby, Liverpool, Largs north of Troon, and the easternmost part of Ireland at Burr Point, County Down. I'll let you think about that for a couple of seconds. For 4 points, a sizeable but partly ruined Norman castle, still inhabited by Lady Egremont. For 3 points, complete with a tilting tower which hangs Pisa-like over Jennings Brewery. Lee!
Cockermouth.
Say it again to me, I love it when you don't do it.
Somewhere up in Cumbria.
The 3 points, Dorothy Wordsworth, William Wordsworth, John Gresham, Fletcher Christian, can you believe he was born there? And built at the confluence of the rivers Cocker and Derwent, which is a bit of a giveaway. So Lee, you get to the 3 points there for Jennings Brewery. And you're in front going into whatever. Lee, lean back. Question 9. Not Stephen Hawking. Who appeared as a card player in the Star Trek Next Generation episode Time's Arrow, being transported from the 1860s to 2369 and back? For 5 points. His adopted name means there are 12 feet of water under the boat in the future. McPhee.
It is Mark Twain.
It is Mark Twain. Yeah. Said with absolute confidence for 5 points.
Times
Arrow, yeah.
11 points, Michael.
How did Guinan manage to beat the Borg to Earth? If the Borg is so shit hot and faster than anything else, how did Guinan manage to know about the Borg when she came across them in Times Arrow?
Strange but true.
Blah, blah, blah. I've dismissed the rest of the question so I can just talk at random.
I don't remember the book.
You never know, yeah, Steve.
No.
No, but she did know.
She encountered them at some point.
Yeah.
It's not real, this Borg shit, you know. You didn't realise that. Get out!
Be on board.
He won several test championships.
In the year 2014, 42, we will have a technical singularity. Which building? For 6 points. Come on, Steve. Rhodes. That's not for any particular reason, it's just because Steve Rhodes supported. 6 points. Which building, designed in the rare and short-lived English Baroque style, for 5 points, built in the first quarter of the 18th century, for 4 points, causing irreparable damage to the reputation of the architect, Sir John Vanbrugh, for 3 points, Tony!
Castle Howard.
Minus three.
Dan. Blenheim Palace.
Dan, that's a good 3 points for you.
Ooh, that's putting you tilt on things.
I love it. Norman, I thought you were doing famously.
How many questions left?
Yeah, I like the dove.
Yeah, you've necked on two, haven't you? Yeah.
Two left. Two left and 1 point separates failure and glory.
Tony and Bean. You've been at this before, Bean. Okay. Six. I left my home in Norfolk, Virginia for 5 points. California on my mind. For 4 points. It was a teenage wedding at the old folks'
Tony.
Chuck Berry.
Correct, wish them well. For 3 points, riding along in my automobile. For 4 points, I've seen it, my baby's having a meal. For 2 points, I'm going to write a little letter, I'm going to mail it to my local DJ. It's a Rocky Rhythm record, I want my job to play. For 1 point, deep down in Louisiana, close to New Orleans, we're back in the room, we're going to Johnny B. Good. We're all knowing we can some songs by which man, the Shakespeare of our generation.
This one was a prompt slang, wasn't it?
Yeah, you could have gone in on Elvis, but obviously with the recent connotations, Chuck Berry.
Chuck Berry.
So, you have got...
Chuck Berry.
5 points for that?
Yeah.
Awesome, 5 points. Look at this. Leap up the table.
Ooh. 9 points. No, no, it wasn't. It was four. It was, it was teenage wedding.
Right, okay.
Oh, sorry.
Thank you. Yeah. I'll just subtract one if you... Where is he?
Yeah.
Oh, so it's actually quite youthful leap, but... That magnificent.
What's currently fourth place?
Three to get. So everybody's in contention.
Three points is in fourth place.
Yeah. Everybody's in contention.
You'll see it.
Yeah.
Last question.
Yeah. Norman's on two, Rose is on two, Tony's on one, Bean's on zero. So 3 points here with the...
Dan's on the bubble.
Erling. You're not allowed to look at the question, because I know Dave Bill's going to struggle me first on this. Airing on the Fox Network in the United States from May the 19th, 2009 to March 20th, 2015. For 5 points, Spanish teacher Will Schuster of...
Glee?
William McKinley High School
of... Oh, yeah!
Rachel Adams, please, correct. So, Dan... That's spoilt our little game, hasn't it? At 4 points, it's all good for the final totals. Going into the last four, part three of this Q12, number three of 2017, it's Michael McPartland, Lee, Simon and Dan. I'm afraid we've got to say goodbye to Norman, Rhodes, Tony and Lee. £500 to go for at the end of the year as well. You're there, and we'll compete. Who do you, now you can see the names, McPhee, Lee, Simon, Dan. McPhee for me has underperformed recently. Lee had a magnificent first two rounds last time, when he could convert it. Simon.
Tony's the shot that's not got through.
And Dan is a past champion. He knows how to win these last rounds. So, yeah. Who do you fancy?
Well, I don't know. It's a tough
old game. Don't do it again.
It's a tough old game, Steve, isn't it? It's a funny old game. I don't know. You can't put a cigarette paper between them. I suppose that's what McPartland's got 11 points out of our favourite McGlaycock.
If you look very carefully on the last film which was released in February, you'll see me point to you and say, you're going to win. I'd always tipped you for it. Sure. I think this is more uncertain. What do you reckon, Dave?
Depends on the... depends how the question's fall. I think... But Patton's showing some form.
I'm tipping Simon, believe it or not, because I think Simon will get the measure like you've got the measure and you've got the measure of the connectivity between 12 questions. But I'd snap off your hand. Fourth to one on any of them. So you've got my money on you, Simon, and everybody has got a chance. So let's look forward to that. That's a good shot, let's
see what's going on.
It's the third part of today's Q12 quiz. With this, you've got a set of questions. All of them are linked to the previous answer, or that's the idea. You may not see the link quite straight away. Sometimes I look at them having written them and don't see the link straight away, but there are links there which can encourage people maybe to take some brave press early on. A brave correct press gets you the points as usual, 2 points as per light speed. but an incorrect press will lose you a life, and you only get 3 lives on this. So, in effect, it's the first of 24 points, or 12 correct answers, who go through to the final, which will be in Pontefract in December for £500 against 11 other people. And we are good to go. Good luck, everybody. Don't forget the questions connect. In what county is Dagenham?
Lee. Essex.
Yeah, the last question was made in Dagenham, I believe. And as the referee said, I am the referee, not the coach. Essex. With a first class career that ran from 1946 to 1967, so you know, who is the only cricketer to score 20,000 runs and take 1,000 wickets for Essex? Nicknamed Barnacle.
Simon.
Trevor Bailey.
Owing to his unspectacular stubbornness at the crease and later on Boyle, for the 26 years he spent working for the BBC on the How to Solve a Problem Like Maria reality TV show. Oh, do I owe Simon some points?
Yeah,
yeah. I can't reach. That'll do. They're not sorting. Which popular song, published in 1933 with music by Harold Arlen and lyrics by E.Y. Harburg and Billy Rose, contains the lyrics, "It's a Barnum and Bailey world, just as phony as it can be, but it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. It's Barnum and Bailey world, just phony as it can be, it's only a paper moon." Yeah, sorry Tony, I should have asked you for that one, I know. Tony was buzzing like hours ago. Be precise. It's only a paper moon. The 160th episode of what TV series serves as a sequel to the siege of AR-558, with Nog suffering from post-traumatic...
Luke P.
Babylon 5.
Lose a life. Nog suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder and phantom pain following the loss of his leg.
You know what you did,
we are going to get... Oh, come on, it's a free guess now. You don't have to tell them that.
Deep Space Nine. From Nog.
Be precise, and it was a follow-on to the question from... non-secretaire question from last month, which you weren't here for.
That was brilliant, yeah.
Yeah, but it was a follow-on question, be precise. You look after your own quizzes, mate, on a Thursday night at... what pub is it?
Smith's Arms, Highburton.
Highburton. And can you believe that he actually... Basically, 3 miles from Highburton, there's a village called Lepton?
Yeah.
Unbelievable. What? It's unbelievable. You can't believe it. It's not allowed. Next one. What? So, Star Trek Deep Space Nine. What part of the Earth's oceans has a maximum depth of 8,648 metres at Milwaukee Deep and is the deepest point?
Atlantic Ocean.
Huh?
Atlantic Ocean. Milwaukee Deep's in the Atlantic Ocean. It's a deepest
point. Actually, Milwaukee is in the Atlantic.
You've got 5 seconds more prompt.
The North Atlantic.
Sorry, man. What part of the Earth's oceans has a maximum depth of 8,648 metres at the Milwaukee Deep and is the deepest point not in the Pacific Ocean? Do you know what? Kind of got a... It's the Puerto Rico Trench I was looking for. Technically, I'm going to let you off that one because technically I'm correct. So just smile at me and say thank you. All right, because technically he wasn't incorrect. I'm not going to put his life back on, we just owe you one. It's too complex a process, mate, honestly.
Bear it in mind then.
The Puerto Rico Trench.
You win a point.
Hey? No point.
Oh, right.
No point, but just no life lost. I should have made the question. Let's get on with this.
So for those of you watching at home, he says he's got 2 lives off, but he hasn't. He's only got 1.
Thank you for that.
We'll bear it in mind.
What would a trencher man do? McPhee.
Eat.
He would eat. Jeez, don't get qualified now. The pent-tailed tree shrew's diet of Bertam palm nectar is, intriguingly, 3.5% what? Simon.
Proof alcohol.
is correct. It's alcohol. It's 3.5% alcohol. Basically, they just lie around and get pissed all day. It's better than being a bonobo. Well, it's better if you like alcohol or sex. If you could cross them over, what a creature that would be. Just get your head along. Next. McPhee?
No,
Simon.
Good
job,
I'm
hearing
it.
In English Monopoly, what is the chance card fine for being drunk in charge? McPhee?
£50.
Dan?
£10.
Simon?
£15.
Lee?
£25.
£20. I'm going to run out of questions here. £20. Who wrote the 1776 magnum opus? An inquiry into the nature and causes of the wealth of nations.
McPhee and Lee.
Go on, just shout it out.
Adam Smith.
Yeah, Adam Smith. Adam Smith and Raith Rovers are from which Fife town on the Firth of...
Simon.
Kirkcaldy. On the Firth of Forth between St Andrews and Edinburgh. Great answer, Simon. Don't ever tell you if you ever played first at 24. Sam's a quarter of the way there. What is the nearest golf course to Kirkcaldy that was on the open rotor? At least until Phil Mickelson's magnificent...
Simon.
Muirfield.
Did you change your mind halfway through that answer there, almost? Muirfield is correct. Yeah, halfway through...
I was thinking it's the Crow Flies. I was thinking St Andrews. Hang on, it's the Crow Flies.
Yeah.
It's Lothian, it's Muirfield.
Yeah, it's just over the first and fourth there. Yeah. Good, great, great thinking, and
back on the circuit.
It is back on the circuit.
Yeah, so they'll allow them in then.
I wouldn't let them in.
So they're allowing transgender.
I have no
women,
idea.
Women members.
Oh, women with members.
In which of the United States is Muirfield Village, the golf community founded by local golfer Jack Nicklaus, north of Columbus? Lee.
Ohio.
Give any year shared, you'll like this, David, shared by the lives of Ming the Clam and Christopher Columbus.
McPhee.
1492.
Nope. Dan. No. Lee.
1417.
No. Simon.
Go for 1505.
1499 to 1506. Ming the Clam is the longest living creature who was born like 5 years before Christopher Columbus's death. It was found in Iceland. So there you go. Scoff that. Simon.
McPhee doesn't get a life off, does he?
Nobody gets lives off, no. We're all very patient there. Keeping their powder dry. What planet was home to Flash Gordon's enemy?
McPhee,
Mongo.
Candy Grand for Mongo.
Or if he comes alive, then we'll be back on.
I'm not going to.
Mongo. Right. Matt Damon. Containing half its country's population, what is the capital and by far the largest city of Mongolia? Lee. It's a good game, isn't it? An island. What's the name of an island? Not any old island. At 1,350 metres, 4,429 feet above sea level, Ulaanbaatar is 5 metres or 18 feet higher than the highest point of which island? The ninth largest and third most populous in the world.
McPhee, Great Britain.
He's correct.
Ties us back to a question from earlier, I believe, that, doesn't it?
They think they're all disjointed. You've got to be here to realise the continuity. That's Great Britain is the answer. Beating Darwin, Shakespeare and Newton, who was voted third greatest Briton in the BBC?
McPhee. Princess Diana.
Alton on the floor and chuckle. Yes, Prince of Diana in the BBC 2002 poll. McPhee. Doing it famously. How's life in the North Atlantic? Who stated to the press in 2002 that Prince Harry had already been born by the time he began his...
McPhee.
McPhee.
James Hewitt.
They don't look much like
it, do
they?
No, they don't.
No, nothing like. Which regiment of which James Hewitt was a member was formed in 1992 under the Options for Change reforms by the Union of the Life Guards and the Blues and Royals? We'll give you a chance in a minute.
Going for the Guards Regiment.
McPhee.
Household Cavalry.
McPhee's got the right answer there. That opens things up very nicely between you and Simon. Dave, were you on Household Cavalry
yeah.
there? You look a bit like Prince Harry as well. You were dabbling.
James Hewitt's had my mum, he'll be having worse.
Household Cavalry. Named after a capital city. Bear that in mind because it goes on forever. In which battle of September the 11th and 12th, 1683, did 20,000 Polish, Austrian and German cavalry, led by the Polish King Jan III Sobieski and spearheaded by 3,000 heavily armed Polish hussars, charge the Ottoman lines in the largest cavalry charge in history?
Yeah, which is something we should all know, isn't it?
Have a guess, named after capital city, go on.
Sarajevo.
No.
Vienna.
Yes.
Vienna.
He's off to me.
Hey?
He's off to me.
Always one.
Kind of washed the taste of that away.
And George Orchis was a bit of a song.
That's quiz joke number one, the next one's John Cage. Oh, shut up, you.
Okay. My ex-wife Angela and which television landlord both had cats? Lee?
Rigsby.
Both had cats called Vienna.
Oddly enough, Lee got that question.
Lee on 9, Simon 10, McPhee 15. Hello. Champ. Rarely seen above 1.5 metres, though it has been observed at up to 5 metres, what two-word term applies to the slow upward movement of water in the lower sections of walls and other ground-supported structures by...
Simon.
Rising damp.
You are slow, guys. Come on. Rising damp. Marsh gas, natural gas, carbon
Lee? Methane.
Oh, yes. Blah, 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 blah. Fire damp and CH4. Oh, yes. Methane. Lee?
Careful, Danny.
Sorry, I've had a coffee fit.
Curry's got the parody now.
Okay,
you okay now? Gobbed all over my curry.
Yeah.
It's cold enough as it was.
That bit was deliberate.
Chaos towards the end of the day in here. Methane was discovered and isolated by which Italian scientist and nobleman between 1776 and 1778 when studying marsh gas from Lake Maggiore? McPhee.
Walter.
Yes.
It's weird at the end.
Scientist and... noble man,
yeah, that's when you know
it's going to be that.
I didn't take was in.
Volta, yeah. Don't worry, you've only lost one life.
I know.
A PP3 battery, that's those oblong ones initially developed for transistor radios, deliver what voltage? Come on, you see, baby, P.
15.
Simon.
12.
Dan.
10.
Lee.
24.
9. 9 volt batteries.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, come and join in and just raise the standard of this quiz, will you, people? 9. Aye is the Amharic word for what? In Armenian, it is voch, Albanian, it is Joe. In Polish, nie. In French, Lee?
No.
In Polish, nie. In French, non. And in German, nein. I'll laugh about it, Jerry. Sorry. Lee.
Good point. Dialect of Albanian is a Pascal keg.
I've no idea, but that's a strange term, isn't it?
Pascal keg. Pascal keg.
Tosco keg.
Two dialects of Albanian.
Yeah, you go to Albania, you want to get mugged? Aye. Next one. In which country is the Kaname and his son Zeame, or in which country did Kaname and his son Zeame develop no theatre?
Japan.
Come on, Simon, you're letting me down. For what is turning Japanese as the cod Lee?
Anika. Oh, wrong anyway. It's the right question.
Oh, you idiot. But
masturbation.
You said that with like prior knowledge, yeah. If we come back to vapors, a euphemism. It's McPhee.
Oh, fantastic. Any quiz that has wanking as an answer.
Now, at the moment, it took us 27 questions for Dave Bills across the line last time out. I think it took about 70 when you got over the line, but we're on 29 questions now, and you're 2 questions away from a win. Adopting the slogan, "It makes your dick bigger and your pussy wet," at only 51 in the Alexa list of most popular websites as of December 28, 2016. I've done considerable research on this to prove it. Which Canadian-based site is the most visited pornography portal?
Pornhub?
2 points. I didn't even have to look at
yours. I didn't even know that.
I'm going to actually go to the board of Fair Trade already. It does not make your dick bigger. No. For years and years.
You've got a lot of research in.
Well, that
other
pad trousers
is
big enough, so I wouldn't know.
So. I wish you could see Steve Rhodes smile right now. It's enchanting. The internet is for porn. Everyone's a little bit racist, and if you were gay, were all tunes from which.
Thank you.
It's correct. We have got another fabulous winner, last year's champion, managed to get into his stride, especially kind of after 4 or 5, you know, if you've got 4 or 5 points under your belt. And after you've lost that life, which wasn't a life, Mike McPartland gets through. Well done, Simon, well done, Dan, well done, Lee. Better luck next time, babies. You never have to do that again. You can set some questions. Thank you for participating. Thank you for watching. Don't forget, the 12th of every month, you'll see a Q12 at 12 o'clock noon. For those of you who've got jobs with the civil service and nothing better to do. And the rest of you, tune in at 8:30 every Monday to watch Lightspeed Quiz on YouTube. If somebody, somewhere, would like to kind of sponsor something and get your name behind us over here, hey, we wouldn't mind that. That would be terrific.
Not Pornhub.
Pornhub, you're welcome to. anything apart from quickly.co.uk, you haven't sponsored. In fact, you are. Who cares? It's all good fun. It's all great people who come down here. The questions are great. The answers are great. The people are great. And the round of applause is great. Thank you very much.